फिलहाल तो यूं है कि कुछ कर नहीं सकते, जिंदगी झंड है लेकिन बढ़ नहीं सकते.
What went wrong is just that COVID happened, this pandemic happened. It just took a part of my life and just ruined it, crushed it.
Hello everyone and welcome to my channel, My Mind Is Art. Welcome to my series #CanWeInCanada. Share with you about my timeline, my Canadian timeline, and how I got my visa in 2.5 months, how I got my study permit in 2.5 months, and also am I going to Canada, am I not going to Canada, what was that last video about, and everything about Canada basically, and my journey and my experience and my process. So if you're interested, then please stay tuned and please continue watching till the end, because I have so many updates and so many points to share with you guys. Well, yeah, if you are interested, then continue watching. Okay, so it all started back in 2018 around April and May when I finally decided that yes, I have to go to Canada. Actually, my friend's cousin just came back from Canada, so I was like, yeah, I was very inspired and influenced that yes, मुझे भी जाना है Canada पढ़ने and मैं भी जाऊँगी, कितना अच्छी life होगी. I was very, you know, influenced by the Canadian life, कि वहाँ पे ऐसे अकेले रहूँगी independently, I'll go for grocery shopping, I'll go for job hunting and all that. So the first step is giving IELTS. So I gave my IELTS in August 2018. If I'm looking down, that's because I have my notes in my diary. So yeah, I gave my IELTS in 2018 August and I scored an overall 7 band. That was a pretty good score. When I gave IELTS, I got a little demotivated and afraid, and I felt like I won't be able to survive on my own without my family, because I come from a joint family. So kabhi akele rahi nahi hu. So I thought that abhi bhi nahi reh paungi and kuch nahi ho payega, so let's just leave it. Nahi jana Canada. Then an year passed, and the next year in 2019 in June, I again started planning for Canada around May June, and I thought ki nahi ab to jana hai, but then I again gave up ki nahi main nahi reh paungi. I know that was like yeah. So I again started feeling homesick, how will I be able to survive without my family, without my parents, without everything and my friends and all that. So I again dropped the plan. This happened 2 times already. So 2 months fast forward, in around August, I again started planning to go to Canada, and this time I finalized it that nahi, mujhe jana hai, and I will go. I started planning, I went to IDP, I hired a consultant again, I asked like the respective consultant that ma'am, ab mujhe jana hai, let's start applying, I am ready for everything, let's do it. So she said okay, let's do it, and I planned to apply for May 2020, because January bahut jaldi ho jata, October se January was like really quick, my family ko bahut mushkil ho jata, and September and like May option mein tha nahi, May 2019. So I decided that let's apply for May 2020, and we started applying. So on 31st October I applied for Sheridan. I started applying to colleges from October. Now on 31st October I applied to Sheridan, on 11th November I applied to Douglas, on 19th November I applied to Humber College, 19th November I applied to Fanshawe College as well, and on 28th November I applied to Centennial College. So I applied to total 5 colleges within a span of 1 month, October to November. Now within a week of applying to Humber College, I got my rejection letter saying that my IELTS will be expired in August 20, so they won't be able to accept me as a student in September 20, because as I said, my IELTS will be expired. So I was really disheartened and I was worried ki ab kya hoga, kya hoga. I am not like habitual of rejection, like in studies academically. So failure ki bhi kuch aadat nahi hai. See, I have been an average student all my life, above average. So that was a very disheartening ki, oh my god, mujhe rejection mil gaya, mera offer letter deny ho gaya, mujh mein kami hai. And I had a very low self-esteem. But then after some time, on 2nd December, I got my
offer letter from Douglas College, and I was so happy. I was on cloud nine, and you won't believe it, guys, I cried. My consultant called me and she said that, hello Tanvi, how are you? What are you doing? And congratulations, you got your offer letter from Douglas. And I started crying and I was overwhelmed. I was so overwhelmed that, oh my God, I got an offer letter from Douglas College. Wow, that's so happy. And all that thing, you see, I hope you understand. So what happens in Douglas College is actually like there is no application fees in Douglas. So what they do is we apply, and then if we get LOA, then we have to pay the application fees. So as and when I got the offer letter on the same day, I paid the application fees. But then my family started saying that wait for other colleges, abhi tuition fees mat pay karna and all that. So I waited, and within 4 days, like on 6th December, I got the offer letter from Fanshawe College, and I was like, oh my God, wow, that's so great. I got admission from another college. So I got my LOA from Fanshawe on 6th December for May 2020 intake. And I was again on cloud nine. I was overwhelmed and I was feeling very confident about myself that no, humber, matlab mujh pe kami nahi hai, wo humber nahi chahta mujhe, because mera IELTS expire ho jayega. I had a very high self-esteem at that moment. Ki chalo, aisi kuch baat nahi hai, mujh mein kuch kami nahi hai. So after that, we were in confusion whether to choose Fanshawe or to Douglas. Both colleges gave me a time period of 20 days to pay my fees. So a short story, I have a distant cousin living in Canada with his family. So my family was preferring ki unke thoda aas paas hi ho jayegi, but abhi unke thoda aas paas hi mil jaye. And Douglas is in, I guess, Vancouver, which is very far. And Fanshawe was in Ontario only. Doori hai jahan bhaiya rehte hain, but still, it was nearer than Douglas. So we decided that, okay, I'll get admission into Fanshawe. And within 2 days, on around 7th to 8th December, I paid my college fees, tuition fees of Fanshawe. I did a bank transfer, wire transfer. And my college received the fees on 11th December. It takes around 3 to 4 days. I'm telling you guys, I was so afraid because wire transfer karna tha, itna bada amount tha, around 8 lakhs, 9 lakhs rupees the, and I was so worried ki, oh my God, main kuch galti na kar do, paise kho na jaye, ye na ho jaye, wo na ho jaye. You know, so I got a confirmation letter from college that yes, they have received the fees on 11th December, and I had a sigh of relief that finally, chalo, kuch kharab nahi hua, ho gaya. After paying the tuition fees, the next step is to get your medical test done. So I got my medical test done on 14th December. Again, I was very worried ki kuch kami na aajay, kuch deficiency na ho, kuch ye na ho jay, wo na ho jay. You know, all these what ifs, every student, probably you are also going through that, maybe. Well, yeah, I went through the same. So on 14th December, I got my medical done. What the next step was to pay my GIC. So I purchased GIC on 24th December, just a day before Christmas. So GIC was, I guess, around 5.5 lakhs INR. So I purchased GIC on 24th December. And again, when I was transacting for GIC, I was very afraid ki papa ka loss na kara do, paise kho na jaye, kuch gadbad na ho jaye mujhse and all that. So after that, moving forward, next week on 31st December, I applied for visa. After 3 days, I got my biometrics done on 3rd January. And then all I had to do was wait for my visa to get approved. And because visa apply karne mein bahut sari formalities hoti hai, you need to have a great SOP, you need to relate your SOP with the everything, and you need to basically convince the visa officer ki haan main Canada jane yogya hoon, and I will not stay in Canada, I will come back after my education, I have a family here, and everything of that sort. So I did that in my SOP. My SOP was bomb. It was really good. Within a week, I got my visa on 9th or 10th January. Within a week, I got my visa and I was on cloud nine again. That yes, ab to koi rok hi nahi sakta. Ab to mujhe visa mil gaya. Ab to main ja hi rahi hoon Canada. Ab to sab kuch hi theek ho raha hai. Ab to like no one can stop me. I am invincible. So yeah, that happened. I got my visa and I was very happy ki chalo theek hai, ek bari mein pass ho gaya. And see, I started from October, and in January itself, I in fact started from November, and within January, like by January, I got my visa also. Within 2.5 months, I got everything done. Like literally, my process was this smooth. It just took me 2.5 months to get my study permit. So after like getting visa, we have to submit a passport for stamping. So next day I went and I submitted my passport, and then after 2 days I got my passport back. I got an email ki haan, aap passport le ja sakte ho, le jao. So I went to the like office again and I picked my passport, and I had my passport with the visa stamp on it, and I was very happy. So after a day or two, or maybe a week, I booked my flight booked with Lufthansa Airlines to fly to Canada on 26th April 2020 because my college was commencing from 4th of May. My classes were commencing from 4th of May. So yeah, I booked my flight, I started shopping on and off, I packed my luggage almost. I bought a lot of clothes like which I found suitable, and I bought a lot of other things as well, like boots. I did not have boots, so yeah, I started my shopping and a lot of things. And then
March happened.
What happened in March? COVID happened. And I have nothing to say. Us waqt I was like, yeah, so in March COVID happened, pandemic happened, and all my dreams of going to Canada shattered. I was so happy that yes, I'm finally flying to Canada after 3 years or after 3 trials, but then this COVID and this pandemic just ruined all my plans. My college was kind enough to like postpone the intake, and I applied for September. Like, I asked the college to defer my intake to September, hoping that circumstances will be a little in my favor by September. So, but then again, my classes are commencing from 24 September. were supposed to actually, but yeah, I have applied for withdrawal now. So just in case you were waiting for this question, like whether am I going to Canada or whether I'm not, here is the answer. I'm not going to Canada because of this COVID-19 situation. Yeah, so I applied for September intake. Like, I asked them to defer my intake, and they very easily did it because meri koi galti nahi hai na, COVID situation chal rahi hai. So I was supposed to fly now in September, but my family is now like, you just cannot go, you won't be able to survive there because abhi to tum ghar pe ho, wahan pe jaake tumhe akele rehna padega kyunki classes online ho gayi hai, hamara September intake is online, and wahan pe rehna bahut mushkil ho jayega tumhare liye. You won't be able to live alone, ghar pe pade rahoge, job bhi nahi milegi, how will you survive and all that thing and all those things. So yeah, in short, I'm not going to Canada. I have applied for withdrawal and I'm just waiting for my refund. My situation right now is more of like, फिलहाल तो यूं है कि कुछ कर नहीं सकते, जिंदगी झंड है लेकिन मर नहीं सकते. It's like actually, like I cannot do anything. I cannot just go out of India because like I just can't. It's so harsh. I won't be able to live there alone and all that. So yeah, finally I've come to a conclusion that the universe never wanted me to go in the first place. I kept trying, but the universe kept pulling me back. So yeah, I hope whatever, like I believe I whatever happens, happens for good. So I hope, I believe there is something good in this as well. Now let's see what I will do. Of course guys, Canada was like, higher studies in Canada was an excuse. I did not want to study in Canada. Basically, I just wanted to go and explore myself. I just wanted to see how the world is out there like. And yeah, so that is not happening, by the way. Yeah, I'm not going to Canada. I'm telling you again, I am not going to Canada. The video I posted was pre-filmed. I have more videos which are pre-filmed, so I am going to post them because they are very informative. And for all those who may be planning to go to Canada, I hope, I trust the videos are useful for you, and I trust it helps you. Well, yeah, that was my story. That was my timeline. This is all what happened, and this is my Canadian story. Yeah, so, okay, so the next topic, the second part of the video is how I got my visa in 2.5 months, how I got my study permit in 2.5 months. Okay, so what happens guys, जब आप कॉलेजेस में अप्लाई करते हो, सबसे पहले आपका IELTS का स्कोर होता है, आपकी 10th की मार्कशीट होती है, आपकी 12th की मार्कशीट होती है, आपकी ग्रेजुएशन की मार्कशीट होती है, आपको सब कुछ उसमें आपके सारे एकेडमिक डॉक्यूमेंट्स अपलोड करने होते हैं. तो इफ़ यू हैव अ वेरी स्ट्रॉन्ग एजुकेशनल बैकग्राउंड, कि आपके मार्क्स वगैरह अच्छे रहे हैं, तो ऑब्वियसली दे वुड सेलेक्ट यू. सो आई हैड अ फेयरली गुड एजुकेशनल बैकग्राउंड. एज आई सेड, आई हैव ऑलवेज बीन एन अबव एवरेज स्टूडेंट, तो मेरे मार्क्स काफ़ी अच्छे थे, तो उससे मेरी प्रोफाइल बहुत ज़्यादा स्ट्रॉन्ग थी. सो इट्स लाइक कि उनके पास रिजेक्शन का कोई इतना ज़्यादा चांस नहीं था. तो या सो दैट वॉज द मेन केस. एंड उसके बाद जब हम वीज़ा अप्लाई करते हैं, तो उसमें हमारे पास 2-3 डॉक्यूमेंट्स होते हैं. सबसे पहला होता है SOP. SOP स्टेटमेंट ऑफ पर्पस. वो एक ऐसा डॉक्यूमेंट होता है जिसमें हम वीज़ा ऑफिसर को एक लेटर लिखते हैं, एक तरह से एक एप्लीकेशन लिखते हैं, जिसमें हम उन्हें बताते हैं व्हाई एम आई गोइंग टू कैनेडा, व्हेन आई विल बी रिटर्निंग, why I will be returning, why I chose that particular course, why I chose Canada, why I chose that particular college, and all these questions. Basically, you have to sell your application to him or her. So I did that. I wrote an amazing SOP. I'm good at writing, so yeah, mera SOP bahut acha tha. I related it very beautifully with my course in graduation, with my stream in graduation. So that helped. मैंने अपना ग्रेजुएशन और अब जो मैं अप्लाई करी थी कोर्स के लिए पीजी के कोर्स को दोनों को अच्छे से रिलेट करके दिखाया बिकॉज ऑफ विच प्रॉब्ली माय एसओपी वाज अ ग्रेट सक्सेस एंड मैंने जीआईसी भी परचेज कर लिया था मैंने अवेलेबल फंड्स भी दिखा दिए थे मैंने अपने पेरेंट्स की नेटवर्थ भी दिखा दी थी कि मेरे को अगर सब की इफ बाई चांस मेरे को अगर वहाँ पे कनाडा जाकर इमरजेंसी हो गई कोई मिसहैपनिंग हो गई तो अगर मुझे फंड्स की जरूरत है तो माई पेरेंट्स विल बी एबल टू प्रोवाइड फॉर मी अगर मैं ये नहीं दिखाती तो मे बी मेरे को वीज़ा नहीं मिलता बिकॉज ऑब्वियसली कैनेडियन गवर्नमेंट वोंट वॉन्ट कि उनके टेरिटरी पे कोई ऐसा इंसान आए जो उनके रेजिडेंट्स के लिए जो कैनेडियंस हैं उनके लिए एक लाइबिलिटी बन जाए बिकॉज नो वन वुड वॉन्ट दैट तो मेरा फाइनेंशियल बैकग्राउंड अच्छा था मैंने उसमें ऐसा अपने एसओपी में शो करा एंड मेरी एजुकेशनल बैकग्राउंड अच्छा था एवरीथिंग वॉज इन फेवर So yeah, that is the reason why I got my visa within 3 months. So also guys, I am providing you with a service, with a free service of examining your SOPs. If you want me to do that, then please mail me. I have my mail in the description box. You can check the mail and you can mail me your SOPs and you can write in the subject that review my SOP and that. I can help you guys because I feel like I did a fairly good job, so maybe I can help you. And I would like, yeah, मैं नहीं चाहूँगी कि आप लोग कनाडा नहीं जाओ just because I could not go. No, I would definitely want कि आप लोग कनाडा जाओ because it is a beautiful country, it is a beautiful place. Racism इतना नहीं है कनाडा में. It's good. What went wrong is just that COVID happened, this pandemic happened, because of which all my dreams are shattered. One more thing, guys. All those videos which I'm going to share, the last video and the videos which I'm going to share now in the subsequent 1 or 2 weeks. These all are based on my experience, and your experience may differ. But that, like, I'm sharing my experience in these videos, and I hope, I trust these videos turn out to be useful for you or your family or your friends. All the information is authentic from my sources, and yeah, I did not get a chance to go to Canada, but all that happens before Canada. In India, I have tried to film and record everything, and I'm going to share my experiences with you. Also, all those videos are pre-filmed in January because I was supposed to fly in April, so I pre-filmed my content, but yeah, that did not happen, so I'm uploading it finally now because Canada is not happening now. So I thought of sharing the videos finally so that it may help at least, like, if even if the video helps one of you, I'll be great. Yeah guys, that's it for the video today. I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope aapko kuch seekhne ko mile meri is video se. I wish you all the best guys. If you're going to Canada, I wish you get your SOPs and your LOAs and your visa within time and on time. Well, yeah, that's it for the video guys. Bye bye, take care.